So something y'all may not know about, unless you've been on our behind the scenes tour, wink wink, nudge nudge, is that we have two cheetah facilities. Most of you have probably seen the Robert Bijaus Family Cheetah Conservancy along the scenic drive, but the other we have tucked away. Some might ask, why would you have two facilities just for cheetahs? And I would let our carnivore curator, Jason, explain why. Like this.
Hi, we're in the IMA cheetah facility. It was actually built in 1989, basically because we were having success with breeding and we needed more space. So we do move our cats from facility to facility. Some cats stress out when they're on the drive-through, when there's a lot of public interaction. So we can move them down to this IMA facility where it gives us an opportunity to breed in a quiet setting down here and also have cats on display up top.
So yeah, we breed a lot of cheetahs around here, and this is a huge help to move them from place to place. But did you know sometimes animals, like people, need to be quarantined? And this facility helps with that.
There's many factors that benefit having this IMA facility. One of them is the fact that our population is split in half. It limits disease transmission between all of our collection here. So if we have an outbreak of a virus or something in our other facility, we can contain it to that facility, and these cats down here are safe and quarantined from it.
And speaking of quarantine, believe it or not, the COVID-19 pandemic is actually having an effect on the breeding of cheetahs.
We have to take care of these animals no matter what's happening in the outside world. They need care on a daily basis, so we are here doing everything we can and have to do to take care of these animals. We do have some challenges that have been in the forefront now. One of those is costs to take care of the animals. For instance, to feed a cheetah, it costs $6 to $7 a day per cheetah. We have a lot of cheetahs, so that adds up. We also are having challenges with animal shipments because of budget cuts at many facilities and limited staff. Transfer of animals is essentially not really happening. And if it is, it's on a very small scale. That's going to change a lot of the ways we manage these cats.
So as always, we are thankful for supporters like you who make the conservation of animals possible.